In 1 hour, the sun supplies enough energy to provide humankind's energy needs for one whole year. We need to tap into that energy. If you can do that, we can power the world. Solar panels have had a long history of 40 years. We're gradually making improvements in how well they can convert sunlight into electricity. So the best cells are about 20% efficient. That means 20% of the sunlight hitting those cells is going into electricity. The next few years, we'll see improvements in efficiency to up to maybe 25%, even 30, 40% more efficient. So more of that sunlight is being used for electricity production. The cells which I work on use silicon crystals. It's a mature technology, but every little extra percentage of efficiency we can eke out of silicon will make them more efficient and provide more energy to people. And we're looking at doing it at very low cost. So our method that we use to texturize our silicon, we essentially use one chemical, road salt, calcium chloride, and we use 1 volt of electricity, and we remove the oxygen from the top of the silicon, and we get this porous structure. By giving a textured surface, we have a cheap and sustainable way of trapping light. So we've managed to bring down the reflectance to less than 1%. Makes the material very, very black, and it's very black because it's good at absorbing light. So the more light which it absorbs, the more electricity you can get out. What's helped the expansion of solar energy has been something very basic: the cost of the raw materials. So silicon, which is essentially sand, the cost of producing silicon ingots from which we make wafers, from which we make the cells, the costs have plummeted. They were maybe $800 per kilogram 10 years ago, and now the cost of silicon is only a few dollars. Industry is now looking at making their production lines so efficient so that the energy used to make a cell is very low. Already the energy produced by a solar cell will pay back the amount of energy took to make it within 2 years. One of the challenges of PV is how they look. With new materials and technologies, we can move away from black solar panels into beautiful coloured glasses. We can use materials called perovskites. Perovskites are very good at turning light into electricity, and we can make them different colours. So we can incorporate solar panels into the architecture of new buildings. You can have a beautiful stained glass window, which not only looks good, it's also generating electricity. Every square metre of Earth has around 1 kilowatt of the sun's energy. We're looking at tapping into that energy, making use of that energy more efficiently to power our homes, hospitals, schools and factories, using new materials and new technology. That's where the future will go.